Hi there, George Frilingos back again with George's tips on how to make your bowling experience more memorable. Today, I'm going to talk about the foul line, the lanes, and the pins. First of all, the foul line. Now, there's two main reasons why you don't want to cross the foul line. The first reason being that if you cross the foul line, such as this, it gets recorded as a foul and a zero score. We certainly don't want that. The second reason, and the most important reason, is that on the other side of the foul line, there is oil. Now, this creates a very slippery surface and a very dangerous surface if you cross it. With the momentum you generate when you take your approach, if you step over that foul line and hit this oil, you're going to fall over. We certainly don't want that to happen. Now we're going to talk about the lane. Now, the lane, being an American-based sport, is 60 foot in length. So in metric terms, it's about 20 meters. Now, what you'll find in all bowling centers across the world are some common denominators. One of them being the arrows. Let's go have a look at them. Now, these arrows are located at the 20 foot mark, which is one third down the lane, and they're used for targeting. You'll see there's seven arrows, one in the middle and three on each side. By combining your approach and using your arrows as guides, your ability to hit where you want to hit and throw a lot of strikes is greatly increased. Another aspect of bowling is the pins. These pins weigh almost 2 kilos, so you can imagine, not easy to knock down. A little bit about the pins actually. They're made out of maple, not plastic, which people think. They also have a double void in them. Now, the benefit of that is that if a solid pin hit the lane, it basically, it'd stay there, it wouldn't jump around very much. That double void actually creates the pin's ability to move around and fly around and hit other pins. Now, a lot of people ask me, what's the best way of throwing a strike? Should I just hit the middle pin? Well, technically, that's correct, but you shouldn't try to hit it straight on. Right now, with that ball where it's positioned now, if you hit it straight on, that middle pin is actually going to split the two pins behind it, go straight back, and that's not going to be able to take out those pins in the corner. So usually you're going to leave a split, which involves two pins on either side of the line. The best way and the optimum way of throwing a strike is if you're right-handed, you hit the head pin to the right side, like this. So what you want to do is put the pin directly between that first pin and the next pin to the right, which is the 3-pin for a right-hander. If you do this, you'll be throwing certainly a lot more strikes than you usually do.